match day, Hollywood Square, our Riz from St. Elsewhere, Ed Begley Jr. Playmate of the Year, Shannon Tweed. Chris Travolina. Hollywood Square's hour, Gene Rayburn and John Bauman.
Welcome one and all to the Match Game, Hollywood Square's Hour, a marriage of two of your favorite TV games. I'll be hosting the Match Game.
And a little bit later on, I'll be handling Hollywood Squares.
Do tell. Listen, we saved you a seat right on the aisle here. No smoking permitted on the aisle. And now, audience, would you join me? A brisk round of applause for our beautiful stars. Hello, stars.
Hi, Gene.
I love
stars are out.
Good to see you, Gene.
On yesterday's Hollywood Squares, you were not called on once.
Not called on at all, but I know that'll change today.
Well, just for the heck of it, give us an answer.
Detroit and the Monroe Doctrine was enacted in 2854. I don't know.
Good. Thank you very much. Are you ready to have a go at it, Shannon?
Boobs.
No. When I tell you, yes. Although we don't doubt it for 1 minute. All right. Now, let's have a brisk round of applause for Lisa Gold and Mary Suggs.
Yay!
Hello! We want to find out about these ladies, so we'll begin with Lisa, and she'll tell us a little bit about herself, won't she?
Hi, Gene. I live in Santa Monica, California. I'm single. I'm an aspiring musical theater performer and hopefully Broadway bound.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
What is your vocal range?
I have about a 3.5-octave range.
Good for you, Lisa. All right. Good luck in that ambition and here, too. Mary, tell us about you, please.
Hi. It's nice to be here. The most unusual thing about me is my voice. I'm currently a graduate student at Loyola Marymount University here in Los Angeles. I waitress in my spare time.
Yeah. Well, Mary, let me tell you something. If you take a deep breath now and hyperventilate a little bit, like that, let's all hyperventilate together. All right. See, that'll calm you down. Get a little oxygen in, you're all right. And I must tell you something, Mary. The first thing you learn in show business, if you have any good teachers, one must never, ever do the obvious joke. So not one person among these stars is going to say one word about your voice, Mary.
No.
Not a word.
Could we do a trio thing? Lisa and the girl there and I, could we sing a song together? From Wizard of Oz?
Follow the yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick road.
No.
Follow the yellow brick road. If ever a whiz, there was.
Thank you.
Yay.
All right. We're going to play the match game now. The object here is to match as many of the celebrities as you can. We'll play three rounds, and the contestant who has matched the most celebrities at the end of the game will go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares. And Lisa, you won the toss. That means you go first. Do you want A or B?
I'd like A, please.
A it is. Or Lisa. In France, Marie Antoinette said, "Let them eat cake." In America, Ronald Reagan says, I don't do Ronald Reagan. Do you do Ronald Reagan?
Well, I certainly intend to see to it that, well, things are, well.
Mr. President.
Come in.
I would be Marie Antoinette and you would be Ronald Reagan, okay?
Okay.
I say, let them eat cake.
And in America, Ronald Reagan says, let them eat
Write something. Did you hear that, Lisa? Okay. Charles is the host emceeing a function immediately following this program. That's why he's all decked out.
I won't say anything about Mary's voice, but if I talk like her, it's because the waist on the tuxedo is 32 and I'm a 37.
Ready over here. Okay, Chuck, here we go. Ready or not?
No.
No?
I don't know.
All right. Lisa, in France, Marie Antoinette said, let them eat cake. In America, Ronald Reagan says, let them eat blank.
Dog food.
Let them eat dog food. Whoa. Well, you know which political party she's affiliated with.
I want to explain my Monroe Doctrine date. It wasn't 2854. I better not go into it. I better drop it right. Which is in this century, certainly. I'm in another century now, but I said, I'm sorry, I said cheese, a big cheese.
Let them eat cheese because he gave away all of that cheese.
He did give away.
All right, there's a little logic there. Don't worry about it, Ed.
Moving right along with another bum answer, steak.
So that's two bad ones in a row. Shannon?
Three.
Cheese, two cheeses, one steak. Want fries with the steak and cheese?
Please.
All right, Marie Antoinette said let them eat cake. Ronald Reagan says let them eat...
Well, considering I spent 14 years playing a character named Bowser, it's logical that I might have said dog food. However, I said something that I think is actually pretty good, crumbs.
Let them eat crumbs.
Aww. Oh, okay.
Not bad. Good. Not a bad answer.
I'm telling you.
Nidra.
Crow.
Let them eat crow. Aha.
That's good.
Nidra, you're okay, baby. Hey, tough act to follow, right?
Well, you know, whenever I'd just like to explain something, I'm 73, my hair is 26. When we have barbecues, we always let them eat hamburgers.
So, that's Lisa's.
Oh, jelly
beans. Now let's see what we have from... Yeah, no one said jelly beans.
Yeah, jelly beans. Jelly beans.
The patient said... This hospital is beginning to worry me. I just found out the chief of surgery is Dr. Blaine. Did you hear that, Mary? Okay, she's thinking about it. Here we go. Ready, Chuck?
Yo!
Chuck's with the chick. Mary Suggs. Patient said this hospital is beginning to worry me. I just found out the chief of surgery is Dr.
Dr. Doolittle?
Dr. Doolittle. That would be cause for worry. Yeah. A lot of good responses here. Did you think of one, Ed?
I did. I thought of one. It's not Doolittle. It's Frankenstein.
That's a very good one. Very good one.
Thank you.
I think we're going to have a lot of good ones. Doolittle's good.
Doctor, no.
That's another good one.
I thought of Strange Love. I never thought of Doolittle, but I said Doctor, no.
Doctor, no. Strange Love is good. No is good. They're all good, really. John must have a good one, too. I just found out the chief of surgery is Dr.
Dr. Frankenstein.
Or Frankenstein.
For you.
Great
as what? Remember? Nidra.
I'm the only one with a rotten answer.
Really?
Dr. Cutter. I know Dr. Cutter well.
Is that your doctor?
Yeah, well, yeah.
He's a surgeon.
Well, we cut some people. Uh-huh.
Sounds like an old vaudeville routine to
well,
me.
Well, I didn't know if anybody would know him, but I...
Yeah, all right. Fred?
Well, I thought like a few of these guys. It's alive! It's alive! Dr. Frankenstein.
Frankenstein.
Okay, there we go. So it's in round one. It's 0-0. Round two coming up in a moment or so. Please pay attention to this in a meantime. Second round coming up. As you see, it's 0-0 right now. We'll go to the round two, and since it is a tie, Mary, and she started last time, we'll ask you to start this time.
May I have A, please?
Yes, you may. Here it is. Gloria said to Weird Willie, hey, what's that little square thing? And Willie said, that? Well, yesterday, just for fun, I stuck my blank in the trash compactor.
Could you read that again?
See you later.
Yes. Can you read that again?
No, you're going to read it right now, loud and clear.
Gloria said to Weird Willie, hey, what's that little square thing? And Willie said, that. Well, yesterday, just for fun, I stuck my blank in the trash compactor. Thank
Not
you
a very good that. Reading, was it?
No, it wasn't.
On a scale of 1 to 10, about a 4, I'd
Should
say.
I call you or
no, don't call me. Leave a picture and a resume, yes. That's very good. Excellent. All right, the upper tier is ready.
Oh, thank you.
Yep. And the lower tier is ready. So, Mary, here it is. Gloria said to Weird Willie, hey, what's that little square thing? And Willie said, that, well, yesterday, just for fun, I stuck my blank in the trash compactor.
I stuck my belly button.
That would be difficult, wouldn't it?
And that
would hurt. That would hurt. I mean, how would you get it in there? I'm a pragmatist.
If it was an Audi, it would be possible, don't you think?
Yeah, if you have an Audi.
Yeah, if it's an idiot.
You can't do it. Yes, if you, right.
Weird Willie had a
All right. And
there's probably a million cutesy and suggestive answers to this question.
Yes. True.
I tried to win some money for somebody.
Right.
So I said the hand, the thing that was
hand, right. Very good. Square finger. End up with a square finger. It's okay. Charles?
I said nose, Uncle Phil.
Excellent. Oh, square nose would look strange. Another nose from Shannon.
Nose.
All right. All right. Willie said, well, yesterday, just for fun, I stuck my blank in the trash compactor.
Square finger.
Right. All right, Nidra.
Nose.
Nose it is. Good response, Fred.
And I said, actually, that he stuck something in there so that you get this little small square thing, and on it it said, Match Game Hollywood Squares. So he stuck his TV in the
TV in there. Came out a little square one-inch tube. Now, Mary, you didn't score again. Let's see what Lisa does this time. A chance for her to forge ahead. Hey, have you seen the new Elizabeth Taylor doll?
No, Uncle Jane.
How new is it?
Yeah, well, here's what happened. You wind it up, and it gets blank.
It's black.
You wind it up, and it gets blank. All right, here we go, Lisa. The new Elizabeth Taylor doll, Lisa. You wind it up and it gets blank.
Married.
Married. That's one possibility.
That's one possibility. I want to make amends for the other things I've said about Liz. I said married, too. I could have said...
All right. That's one for her.
I said married and married... And married.
Okay. Well, I guess we get the idea there, right, Shannon?
Well, I'm sorry. I wanted to say married, but it takes two dolls.
Oh, you know, right.
Wind up the doll, what does, you know, get... That's
right.
Dumb answer.
And it gets married.
Got hungry.
And it gets hungry. Okay. Elizabeth Taylor doll, you wind it up, and it gets married, according to her.
And Lisa thought she couldn't score with this panel.
Right.
Married.
Another one. Three for you, Lisa. Nidra.
Married.
Married. Four for Lisa.
Also married.
Fred makes it five. So, here we are at the end of round two with only one more round to go. She's ahead 5-0, and we'll see what happens with you later. Now, this for you, if you please. Third and final round coming up here now. And as you can see, the score is 5-0. Would you step over here, sir? Bring those cards over here. You, sir, just step over here. Bring those. I've been in television a long time, and I've worked with some cue card people who show up in blue jeans and V-neck sweaters, but I've never had a cue card guy show up wearing a tuxedo.
That's why I get paid so much.
Oh, really? Well, you look very elegant. Thank you. I want you to do it every week, okay? All the time.
Function, of course.
Thank you, Tim. All right, here we go to the third and final round. And Lisa, since you're ahead, you have to go first.
I'll take B, please.
All right. Let's see what we've got here. Only one person. Ah, Shannon. Yes, Miss Shannon. Ah, the fair lass. With
you're
the golden.
Get up.
Yeah, thank you, Charles.
You know how hard it is in this tuxedo?
All right. Here we go.
Isn't there another game we can play like this?
Yes, there is. Easy. Dumb Donald is really dumb.
How dumb?
Thank you. Instead of filling his new Japanese car with gasoline, he filled it with blank. It's easy for you because you're very smart. Charles, you're going to have to give her an answer. Perfect. Perfect. Nothing wrong with that at all. Okay. Lisa, Dumb Donald is really dumb. Instead of filling his new Japanese car with gasoline, he filled it with...
Sake.
Sake. All right. Shannon, it's show and tell time.
Why do you always have to make me look stupid?
You're not stupid at all. Sake is her answer. So there she has all six. Mary, the best you can do is achieve a tie, and you can do that by matching all of the celebrities in this round. Alice said, I'll never go out with Oscar the Undertaker again. On our first date, he tried to blank me. Okay, Chuck, here we go, man. Alice said, I'll never go out with Oscar the Undertaker again. On our first date, he tried to blank me.
Embalm me?
Embalm me. Embalm me.
My sweet embalmable you.
Oh, that's a sick word.
I wanted to say bury me so bad, but I said embalm me.
Embalm. All right, Mary, you've got one. Charles?
I said Barry.
Barry, so that means Lisa wins the game. Come on down here, Lisa. Congratulations to you. Stand right here alongside me. You'll be doing the Hollywood Squares portion of Moment of Soap with the big money. Now we say goodbye to Mary Suggs. Some gifts coming your way. Many thanks for being here on the Match Game. Mary Suggs. There she goes. It's time to switch to Hollywood Squares. We're going to bring out three more celebrities. And I'm going to change places with the host of Hollywood Squares, John Bauman. And we've got lots more excitement coming your way, so don't go away. We'll be right back. Here we go.
A member of our studio audience will receive Quasar's new 13-inch portable television. Features customatic tuning, high-tech styling in a simulated walnut grain finish and super color system furnished by Quasar. And now, it's time for more of the Match Game. Hollywood Square. Our win from We've Got It Made, Bonnie Urseth. Arsenio Hall. From Laverne and Shirley, Eddie Mecca. And taking over, the star of Hollywood Square, John Bauman!
And we'll be right back, you two!
And now, John Bauman and the Hollywood Square.
Thank you. Welcome to the second half of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. And I'm here with Lisa Gold, who has just won the Match Game contest, and three wonderful new celebrities, Arsenio, Eddie, and Bonnie.
Eddie Mecca, Big Ragu.
I found out that other than playing kind of greasers for a long time, you and I have something else in common. We both studied serious classical music and opera. You want to give us a few notes?
Okay, G.
Who wants to hear Eddie sing?
Did you hurt your...
Broke three of our cameras with that. We'll have to start over in another studio. But on the other end of the spectrum, I have with me Lisa Gold. She's ready to take on the returning champion in the game of Hollywood Squares. Let's get into action. And getting into action means we say hello once again to Joseph Hunt, who has come back. He has returned, having already won $5,500, and he's going to go for some more today. Okay, how do you feel about everything so far, Joseph?
Fourth time is a charm.
Okay. Joseph's talking about that he has yet to win the big money, but he still has accumulated $5,500 just from playing our regular games. Not bad. Okay, let's play Hollywood Squares, and we're going to play it until we hear the time's up bell. Now, whoever's ahead at that time is our winner, gets to go on to play Supermatch for up to $30,000. Our first game is worth $100 plus $25 for every square that you capture. Our champion gets to start. That's you, Joseph. Pick a square, any square.
Fred Travellino, please.
What are you doing? What are you doing?
Fred, what have more men done? Walked on the moon or married Elizabeth Taylor?
Walked on the moon or married Elizabeth Taylor. It's close.
Walked on Elizabeth Taylor.
It's close.
It's not her day, is it?
I would say married Elizabeth Taylor.
Okay, Joseph, he says more men have married Elizabeth Taylor than walked on the moon. Agree or disagree for the first square?
I'm going to disagree.
More men have walked on the moon. You are right to disagree. You get the first square. Lisa Gold, pick a star for me.
Charles Nelson Reilly.
Charles.
These are all my roommates. We got nine of us are in the dressing room downstairs.
What a party.
So we're all together in this. It's wonderful.
Charles, if you wear a
clothes rack bend with a lot of leather on it.
What if you wear a toupee every day, Charles.
I don't understand a word you're saying.
I was afraid this might get to you. If you wear a toupee.
Why couldn't you pick her for that?
I'll rephrase
all right,
this, Charles.
Okay.
If one wears a toupee every day.
All right, I wear a toupee. Go on.
If one wears a toupee every day, Charles, about how often should one have it cleaned? Once a week?
You're asking the wrong person.
Once a week, once a year, or never?
I see something about it. Yeah.
There's a bird.
Well, I'm sort of... This is interesting.
Now, wait a minute. That hair is real.
No,
we worked together for 9 years.
No, it's
you
not
never
real.
Told me you wore a toupee.
I do. I have to go out later. Once a day, once a year.
Once a week, once a year, or never. To clean your
toupee. I would go from my own personal knowledge, being a hygiene person, once a year.
Okay.
His toupee meets him in New York.
No, if you let it go, it looks more real. If you take too much care of it, it, you know, it doesn't look right.
Right.
So once a year.
Last time on this program.
This week, yes it is. Okay, Lisa, he says that you should clean your toupee once a year. Agree or disagree?
I'll disagree.
The answer is once a week. You are right to disagree, and you get the square. And Charles' toupee. And $25. Joseph, make your move.
That
was a big order. There's an excellent up there.
Okay, I'll go with Bonnie Urseth, please.
Mm-hmm. Bonnie Urseth.
Yes.
It's your honeymoon.
Ooh.
According to the Kama Sutra, for the first 3 days after your wedding, where should you sleep? On the floor, in the bathtub, or in a hammock?
Well, Kama Sutra, it must be the floor.
Okay, she says you should sleep on the floor. Agree or disagree, Joseph?
I'm going to disagree.
You should sleep on the floor. No, you should have agreed, and your opponent gets the square. Okay, it's a breakthrough for you, Lisa. Tell me where you'd like to move.
I'd like Gene Rayburn to win.
Gene Rayburn to win.
He's a winner.
Yes. Gene, according to Dr. Joyce Brothers, if a man likes a woman with a large bosom and a small derriere, will he tend to be well-organized or disorganized?
Well, I would say that it indicates that she is a mother symbol to him, and in Freudian dynamics, obviously, it's a dependency need. And what was the question?
If a woman has a large bosom and a small derriere, right?
Yeah.
And if a man likes that, is he well-organized or disorganized?
He's disorganized.
Okay, so he says that man is disorganized who likes that woman. Agree or disagree, Lisa?
I'll disagree.
He is well-organized. You're right to disagree, and you win the first game. Congratulations, Lisa. You have $175 to $25 for our returning champion. Okay, we'll be back to play our $200 game in just a minute. Stay with us, everybody.
Stay tuned for more of The Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. Now, back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
Thank you. Our next game is going to be worth $200 and $25 for every square that you capture. The last game was won by Lisa. That means, Joseph, you get to start this one. Pick a star.
Bonnie Urseth, please.
Bonnie. According to a recent study by Playgirl magazine, do women's sexual fantasies more often include a male stranger or a famous person?
Trying to think back, my last fantasy.
Well, tell us about it.
Boy, did you ask.
Tell us a little about yourself.
Stranger.
Okay, so they more often include a male stranger rather than a famous person. Agree or disagree, Joseph?
I'm going to agree.
They often include a male stranger. That's right. You should agree, and you get the first square and $25. Yes, Fred?
As a former president of the United States, I disagree. I know a lot of women have fantasies about me out there, and you know all those tapes that are floating around? Well, there are tapes of me for hours on end.
And away to go, Fred.
Okay, Lisa, if you can still concentrate, pick a square.
I'd like Charles Nelson Reilly again, please.
Mm-hmm. Charles.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was thinking of a stranger. No. It was August 1978, and she was a meter maid in Glendale.
Who has written more stage plays, William Shakespeare or Neil Simon?
So close.
That's a tough one, John.
Neil Simon by about two.
He says that Neil Simon's written more stage plays than William Shakespeare. Agree or disagree, Lisa?
I'll agree.
William Shakespeare has written more stage plays. You should have disagreed. Your opponent gets the square.
Hey, John?
The score is Neil Simon, 37. William Shakespeare, 37. Neil Simon, 25.
Hey, John?
That's the score, up to the minute.
Excuse me.
Yes?
Excuse me. I don't know if Fred told you, but we wrote a stage play.
It's
going to star Sylvester Stallone and Larry Holmes. It's called Getting My Speech Together and Taking It on the Road. We'd like to do a scene from it.
Yeah,
sure.
Okay.
Okay, Joseph, make your move.
Gene Rayburn to win, please.
Gene Rayburn to win. You're an average guy. If your wife is also average, whose heart beats faster, Gene, yours or hers?
Let's see. May I take your pulse, please?
You sure that's all you take?
Go ahead.
Love
you. He'll take whatever he can get. Okay.
Physiologically, I believe the male pulse beats faster. That's why women live longer.
Okay, so you say that your pulse would be faster than your wife's.
Yes.
Agree or disagree, Joseph, for the game?
I'm going to agree.
No, hers would be faster. If you disagreed, your opponent gets the square and blocks. Okay, Lisa. Pick
like
a star.
Fred Travellino, please.
Fred.
Yevol.
Who's in that square now?
That
when the Reagans are alone, Fred.
Excuse me, when that by me?
Yes. When the Reagans are alone.
Yes.
What does Nancy call her husband? Is it Ronnie or Jelly Bean?
Well, all I can say is when we're alone, I call her mommy. And she calls me Jelly Bean. That's why I like those little things on my desk. Makes me think of myself.
So Fred says when the Reagans are alone, Nancy calls Ronnie Jelly Bean.
I'll disagree.
She calls him Ronnie. You're right to disagree, and you get the square. Ronnie. Joseph, take a good look at the board and tell me where you'd like to go.
Nidra Vols to block, please.
Uh-huh. If you miss this one, Lisa takes yet another game. Nidra.
Yes.
You have just murdered your husband.
And not a minute too soon.
You have just murdered your husband and you want to dispose of his body in the world's deepest lake. Would you have to go to Siberia or to upstate New York?
Closer to New York. I'm going to say, Siberia.
Okay, you
say
the
Siberia.
You want to say you
yeah,
say.
Yeah, I'm going to say
Siberia. Let me hear you say Siberia.
Siberia.
For you.
Joseph, she says that the world's deepest lake is in Siberia. Agree or disagree?
I'm going to disagree.
The world's deepest lake is in Siberia. No, you should have agreed. Your opponent gets the square and wins another game. It's Lake Baikal, over 1 mile deep. Okay, she's built up quite a lead, $250 to $75. We'll be back with another game. It's worth $300 in just a minute. Joseph Hunt, our defending champion, could be on the ropes. He's only got $75, and Lisa has $450 so far. However, Joseph, you get to start this game. Pick a square.
Gene Rayburn, please.
Gene.
Again, into the breach.
In Czechoslovakia, the word Rus means Russian if it has a capital R. But with a small R, it's the name of what common household pest?
Rus.
Rus.
It's very close to Serbo-Croatian, a language that I happen to speak.
Would you care to give us a sampling?
Yes.
You are laughing.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, as long as you put your foot in your...
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Do I speak Serbo-Croatian?
Yeah.
Speak that Croatian. Right on. Speak me some Croatian.
There are many cognates between Czech and Serbo-Croatian and Russian and so forth. I don't happen to recognize that one, Rus.
R-U-S, Rus.
Rus. I would say it means insect.
Okay. He says that the common household pest is an insect. Agree or disagree, Joseph?
I'm going to disagree.
It is a cockroach. That's you are right to disagree, and you get the square.
I was just going to say a roach.
Okay, Lisa, he's off to a pretty good start. Make your move for me.
I'll take Arsenio Hall, please.
Arsenio, who has a bigger brain, James Watt or your average bottlenose dolphin?
Is that really a question?
No.
That's it.
No contest.
That's the right guy, yeah.
We can prove this, you know. It sounds funny, but James White has a big head, so I'm sure he... No, he did have a big cranial area, didn't he? But I would say the dolphin. Okay. I'm going to go with Flipper to block.
Lisa Arsenio says that your average bottlenose dolphin has a bigger brain than James White. Agree or disagree?
I'll disagree.
It is the bottlenose dolphin. Yeah, you should have agreed with Arsenio. Your opponent gets the square. Arsenio knows. Okay, Joseph, your move.
Ed Bigley Jr. to win, please.
Mm-hmm. This could win you a $300 game. Ed, you're a pig.
I'll say. I've been hearing that a lot on St. Elsewhere, too, by the way. I don't know if you noticed.
You're a pig, and scientists are offering you alcoholic drinks. Are you more likely to become a lush or to remain a teetotaler?
Well, the little that I know about pigs, they seem to take just about anything they can get into their systems. They're not very picky. I'd say they'd be very likely to become a lush.
Thank you, Doctor.
Yes, you're welcome.
Okay, Joseph. Ed says that a pig who's fed alcoholic drinks is probably going to become a lush. Do you agree or disagree for the game?
I'll agree.
It is become a lush. You are right to agree. You get the square and you win the game. Goodness, we have a flat-footed tie, $450 to $450. Let us clear the board and move on to the next game. Joseph, you won the last game. That means Lisa gets to start. Pick a square. Everyone's important now.
Bonnie or Seth, please.
Bonnie or Seth. According to New Woman magazine, Bonnie, if you just found out your husband is involved with another woman, to keep from losing him, should you stop having sex with him or surprise him with a sensuous activity you've never done before?
Well, if it were Cosmopolitan, I'd say the second one. So this New Woman magazine. I don't think it does any good to stop having sex, so I'm going to say the second. Surprise him.
Okay, so Lisa says that you should surprise this guy with a sensuous activity you've never done before. Agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
You should stop having sex with him. No, you should have disagreed. Your opponent gets a square and $25. Okay, Joseph, it's your move.
Ed Bigley Jr., please.
Okay, Ed Bigley Jr.
Forget him, Ed.
Which sex is more likely to walk in their sleep, Ed?
I believe that's the men.
Okay. He says men are more likely to walk in their sleep. Agree or disagree, Joseph?
I'm going to disagree.
Men are more likely to walk in their sleep. You should have agreed, and Lisa gets the square. Time is up, and we have a flat-footed tie. $475 for Lisa, $475 for Joseph. Okay, a tie game. We have to clear the board, and we will play one more question. Joseph, you answered the last question. That means it is Lisa's turn at bat. Now, what you have to do here is pick a star for me. If you get this right, you will win the game. If you are wrong, Joseph wins. Which celebrity do you choose?
Gene Rayburn, please.
Gene.
Pressure is terrible. My blood pressure is going through the roof.
According to Playgirl, Gene, what woman has appeared on more magazine covers than anyone in the history of publishing?
According to Playgirl magazine, it was Shirley Temple.
Okay, Gene says that Shirley Temple has appeared on more magazine covers than anyone in the history of publishing. For the game, Lisa, agree or disagree?
I disagree.
The answer is Princess Diana. You are right to disagree, and you win the game. Congratulations, Lisa Gold. You are our new champion. This is your first chance to go over there with Gene Rayburn and get set for your shot at the big money. Nice going. Joseph, we do have to say goodbye to you, Joseph Hunt. You're a fabulous player. You're leaving here with $5,975. Thank you. And you're leaving here with our thanks for being so good on Match Game Hollywood Squares.
Thank you.
Attaboy.
Thank you all.
And now, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, John. Hold on, Joseph. All right, congratulations here to Lisa. We'll be back with all nine celebrities and a go at the big money right after this.
Here to play the super match is Gene Rayburn.
Thank you very much, Gene. Congratulations to Lisa once again. It's time now, Lisa, for the big money super match where you can win up to $30,000, shall we?
Yes.
All right. We polled a recent studio audience and got their best response to this blank check. Now, the top answer is worth $1,000, second most popular, $500, and the third. You did it again. You dinged before I said the money. The third is $250. And any of the three of the nine celebrities can be called on to give you an assist here in filling in that blank. Whom do you want to call on first?
Ooh. Arsenio Hall.
Arsenio, you have an answer.
Yeah. Ooh. Rubber check.
Rubber check. All right.
Okay, Fred Travellino.
Canceled check.
Canceled check, two.
Eddie Mecca.
Rain check.
Rain check.
Oh.
We have Arsenio. Yeah. Rubber check, cancel check, and rain check. Now, you may choose one of those, or you may create one of your own. What would you like to do?
I'll take rain check.
You want rain check. All right. Yeah. That's the one that Ed gave you. Let's find out if rain check is up there, and if so, where. May we see the $250 response, please? Paycheck is there. No one gave you that, but that's not bad. The $500 response says... bed check.
Bed check?
Bed check.
Can you say that?
Yes, you can say that. Right. Somebody did. All right, last chance for her answer. Here we go. Blank check. Oh, I'm sorry, Lisa. You didn't match any of the answers on the board, but because you are a champion, we're going to stake you to $100 to play our head-to-head match, okay? Now, you've got the 100. You're going to play the head-to-head match with any star you pick. And each star has in front of him a hidden number, a 10, a 20, or a 30. And if you pick a star with a 10, we'll multiply your money by a 10. And if you pick a star with a 20, we'll multiply your money by a 20. And there is one star up there with a 30. And if you pick that one, you'll play for 30 times $100. Okay? Time to make your pick.
Ed Begley Jr.
All right, Ed. Here we go. She wants to you to reveal your hidden number. Go. A 20. All right, 20 times $100. That means you're playing to head-to-head for $2,000.
Ooh.
And if you're set, here we go. You're going to face me, Ed. Ready? Pork blank. P-O-R-K blank. Well, he's all finished. Your job is to match him. How do you fill in that blank? pork?
Chop.
Pork chop. All right, let's find out what he has to say. What do you say, Ed Begley?
And this is for the 20.
This is...
chop, of course.
Pork chop. Very good. You may kiss him on the lips for $2,000. All right. He's got a total of $2,600. Congratulations to you. We'll be back in a moment. First, these messages. I know we're all very curious to see which celebrity had the big 3-0. So, John, you want to step over and do the reveal with all of them? Ready, set, go. Who had it? 10, 20. Charles!
Charles Nelson.
Charles had it. The big 3-0 there. John, I know you want to join me in thanking these beautiful people. We hope all of you will deign to come back again another
please.
Time, right?
Yes, Gene.
Thank you all. That ends today's session of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. We'll be back Monday with our champion and all 9 celebrities. I'll be here for the Match Game.
And I'll be here for the Hollywood Squares.
Along with the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. Goodbye.
Go on.
A member of our studio audience, Lotus Eve, the Roper Easy Touch Microwave Oven, featuring computerized cooking with 3 memory levels, lets you automatically program exactly the right temperature, hour, and cooking time for any foods furnished by Roper. Because an answer was called out, a Hollywood Squares question was replaced. Due to a scoring error, the program was edited. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. A Mark Goodson Television Production.